this. Mm-hmm. This economy is on life support. We took 5 revenue sources that are currently being collected through taxes that cost us $430 billion a year collectively for filing and compliance. So we looked at corporate income taxes, personal income taxes, capital gains taxes, payroll taxes, and the death tax. Then we said we want a structure where we can expand the base. But the only way to expand the base was to bring in retail sales. And what is the lowest rate that would be simple, fair, efficient, transparent, and revenue neutral? This is how we came up with the 9% rate on corporate tax, a flat rate, personal income tax, a flat rate, and a 9% retail sales tax. So we derived this by using existing revenue numbers. So it is not a gimmick, and we've also had it scored, and it will boost this economy and create 6 million new jobs.
And I know you're going to be coming out with that scoring report soon, right? Can you tell us when?
Yes. We've already had the scoring done. We are just trying to clean it up such that when we present it to the public, it won't raise a lot of questions. So we'll have that done within the next week, and we'll make it available.
All right. So let me ask you this, because we just talked about the poll that came out this afternoon where you're leading in Florida with a significant margin over Governor Romney and by just a point, so within the margin of error, but still in an early voting state, South Carolina. So I just took a few of the early states, New Hampshire, Iowa, South Carolina, Florida. If you look at the current sales tax in those states, New Hampshire's at 0, the others primarily at 6%. So voters in those states watching tonight see that. And let's look at New Hampshire. They go, I'm paying 0 now. Even though Mr. Cain gives me a cut on my payroll tax, I'm getting a 9% sales tax, and I'm getting a 9% income tax rate. A lot of people say that will result in an increase in people at the bottom of the income level in this country.
Here's how I respond. This is something new to the public to say that you're going to pay a sales tax on retail sales of 9%. But at least you know what it is. The problem with our current system is that there are embedded taxes and sneak taxes in the current tax code.
All right, so the fundamental question of regressivity, that a sales tax that applies to clothes and to food, as I believe yours would, hits the people who spend the majority of their income on food and clothes, that being the poorest people in America.
It's not regressive. Take an actual example. The reason some people say it's regressive is because that's the way they think relative to the current paradigm and the current tax code. If I can very quickly, let's take a median income family of $50,000 a year. If you want to use $25,000 a year, just cut these numbers in half. A family making $50,000 a year, which is around median income, mm-hmm. under the current system, they're going to pay $10,200 in taxes. Under the 999 plan, they're going to pay $4,500 for that middle nine, and that leaves them $5,700 to apply to sales taxes that they would pay on that third nine on food and shelter, and then if they buy goods, no taxes on used goods. So the actual purchase behavior, we can't predict, but it is not regressive. In fact, it empowers those that make the least amount of money because you don't pay the sales tax on used goods.